Start recording now before I forget. Hey, Dino. I mean, Bant needed the help. Bant Company was really struggling, so. This deck has way too many threes in it. Against Uzu, I think I have to mulligan this. This has a third shard in it. This isn't great either, though. Howdy back now. That was a good draw. I'll put the hand together. Give us want some kind of consistent damage source. This lets us consistently poke our opponent. Poke, poke, poke. Resolves. Hey, mortals. I don't know how long today's gonna be, but I wanted to finish out this gauntlet anyways. Figure might as well fire it up. My youngest is sleeping. Jake's behaving himself. Another consistent damage source. Well, those first two draw steps just like took this hand from being solidly mediocre to being very reasonable. So next turn we go Shard of Hatred for Blood, activate our champion power, 2-4-8 our opponent down to 13. Hey, Holidays. Yeah, I don't really care about that. I'm just Burning Tendrils it next turn, probably. We don't have an orc in our hand, right? That's sad. So I'm just going to do what I said. I'm going to play this and get a Blood Shard. And then activate Yotul. 2U, 2U, 4U. Opponent's down to 13. Next turn, we can activate Yotul again and do 2, 4, 7 down to 6. And the following turn, put him down to 5, then to, okay. I guess if he has a shard here, he can make, second, okay. That's interesting. I might spend a burn on this guy. I mean, Magic Online sucks, so probably not. Put rage on this. So now, let's see. Can I kill my opponent this turn? I don't think I can. We're definitely activating our champion power. And this does 2, 4. And then this does 3, which is 7. And then this does 3, which is... So we can only do 10 this turn. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to do 2, 4, Burning Tendrils this, which kills the Lixil because this does plus 1 from Yotul. And then burn his Forgotten Monarch so it just stops powering things up. Yeah, I think I like that. Yay, K-Smith. Yeah. So we're going to burn this. We're going to Tendrils this. Do 4 with our activations here, putting them down to 8. And then, if we draw a resource next turn, we get to activate our champion power. If we don't draw a resource, it probably does damage to the face. So, like, good either way. In fact, tomorrow will be the last day we see Magic Online on this stream. It's going to be great. I'm so excited. I'm selling all my crap. Alright, can we still kill him? I think we're short now because of this, right? I think it's activate this, go 2, 4. Yeah, we can only do 7, and then he's gonna block this and gain some back. So this will do 3 when it attacks, and then he'll trade and go back to 4. So, a lot of live draws to kill him next turn. If he has another Midnight Paladin, that would be bad for us. Thankfully, he only had 3 different thresholds when he played the Midnight Paladin. Oh, not gonna let him cast a Infinite Tricks if he's got one. Okay, he's got an Invincible Elixir. So if he has Infinite Tricks in his hand, I think he would have played it out. I don't know. It's close. Got a lot of draws to just end the game here, though. Well, we need to hit a draw to end the game, because otherwise Midnight Shepherd's putting Midnight Paladin back into play, and then we take 5 and he gains 5. Kill him, kill him, kill him. That is not one of our draws that ends the game. We still get redraws, though, right? This is going to hit us for 5 and put him to 9, and these put him to 6, and then next turn we have Crackling Bolts, and yeah, just Crackling Bolt to kill him, I think. Whirling kills him, too. Riders could be really good, or they could be poop, you know, one of the two. Alright, one draw to win the game. One last shot. It's our chance to roll. Hey, Captain. What's going on? The feeding end. Welcome back. Crackle his bolt! Does that do it? That does it, right? That does 3. Pew! Pew pew! Pew pew pew! Pew pew! Get infused. Boom. Got him. So he gained 8 that game when we killed him anyways. And shot. One opportunity. Ember Spire Witches, get in here. Mom Spaghetti, knees weak, arms are heavy. Vomit on the sweater already, but it keeps on forgetting what we wrote. You wanna come in here with Dad? Your brother's not down here, you can come in. Cleave doesn't seem great against what our opponent has going on. Crimson Bolt's medium. I guess it kills Infinite Tricks, but like it doesn't dome him, so like I don't think I want that effect. So, definitely want all the Ember Spire Witches. Maybe I want like one less Pyretic Performer. Those Scorchos aren't stellar. Let's do that. What does the sand do? Sand seems pretty reasonable. Yeah, I'm gonna keep it. It's a little troop heavy. You really want to sit in my lap, huh? So there's a little bit of a break here in the video, and I'm gonna explain that in a second. So we lost the second game due to inactivity because my toddler bumped the suspend key on my keyboard, which I didn't know existed because I'm using a desktop computer. Apparently, there is a suspend key on the keyboard of this desktop computer. And, you know, whatevs. So, yeah. And then when I... After I got the computer back up and unsuspended, my network freaked out and I had to reboot on top of unsuspending. So... That's what happened there. The TLDR. Pulling chat back up now. He was Shard. Perfect. He was reaching across the keyboard to set his tablet where he could watch it while he was sitting on my lap, and he fell forward and bumped it by mistake. So, completely innocent. Our five guards actually are really good. Put him at 12 already. Yeah, we're alive again. Yeah, toddler, I love you, even if you did abuse my stream. Dad loves you anyways. You're a lucky boy. So we do this. Activate this. Do two. Do four. Attack for three. He blocks. All right, well, we're going to win this game mulligan to five because our draw was great and our opponent didn't do anything till turn three. Opponent probably should have mulliganed. I guess he could have Midnight Paladin here, right? Midnight Paladin? Yeah, probably has Midnight Paladin. Okay, sure. Rough. Well, we almost won the one where we mulligan to five. I mean, unless he has a second one, we're not out of this game. He could go Shard Infinite Tricks. He's gaining two this turn. No second Midnight Paladin, and he's still dead? Come on, we mulligan to five, Kismet. Don't give him the second Paladin. Don't do it. Don't give him the second Paladin. Come on, have a heart, Kismet. No second Paladin, one time. We mulligan to five. We lost game two because of toddler aggro. No! Oh, God. All right. Well, you know. Come on. Come on, Crackling Bolt. Come on. Come on, Crackling Bolt. Burning Tendrils. Crackling Bolt. Burning Ember Spire Witch. Okay. So you're saying there's a chance. So you're saying there's a chance. I'll put the chat back on screen after this game. Yeah, you got your monarch back. Oh, I didn't realize this gives a charge. Okay, sweet. I thought this was the other one. Man, I'm glad I started the recording back on. This game was sweet. Here you go. This card having Swift Strike is the nut, too. This deck's very good. Even if we lose this game, this deck's very good. Could you imagine if this draw would have had two more cards in the opening hand? Like, I can't even imagine if we would have had two more cards in our opening hand. How dead he would be. Like, even if they had just been shards, like, the charges would have killed him. Sweet. All right. Well, we 5-1 that. Let me take a second here and set my stream back up. I'll pull the deck list up while I do so. We're gonna make some changes. I think we might play this again. This deck's fun. It's fast. It's fast and fun. Mulligan to five. Lost cash. That's quite the story. Won the match anyways. There you go, Turdler. You're a turd. You know that. Your father loves you, but you're still a brat. I mean, not swinging with the paladin wouldn't have changed the outcome of that game. He couldn't gain life. Yeah, you think this is funny? You think this is a funny game? All right, so let me get my Twitch alerts and stuff set back up. None of that is active right now. As he hits. All right, sweet. That works. Chat box. Launch. Your feet on the desk are in the worst spot, kid. I know. You do what you want. You do what you want. Kids, you know what you're gonna do. All right, sweet. Alrighty. Changes. We have too many threes, right? The pyretic performers have been unimpressive. I don't think I want these. I think we want... You would lose money, because Twitch would take half. And I'd have to pay taxes on the other half when Twitch sends me a check. You can't have the box of magic cards. I'm sorry. It's not for you. I'm going to put you outside the gate if you don't behave. Yeah, hopefully, Captain. That's the plan. Get a little bit of there and a little bit of stuff for everyone. Maybe I've seen these decks have like some kisses in the main. I don't hate that. Like let's get two kisses in the main, I think. Maybe some more ones or twos. Look how pretty that is. It's like so perfectly 12 12 12 right across the board. They're kind of like Flame Tongue Kavus. In the reserves, we want some heat waves. I think we want some heat waves. I don't know if I want these Crimson Bolts. I think our matchup against the Bombas decks is probably pretty reasonable. Don't touch the keyboard. Don't do it. Don't do it. You're on probation, kid. You're on probation. I think I want four kisses post-board in some matchups. Hey, LP fan. I think I'm going to get another one of these in here and maybe cut a Crimson Bolt. We need some other... You want your tablet? Here, I will give it to you. You're not reaching across the keyboard anymore. All right. You going to go out there? There you go. As you will. All right. So another card we could play in the main deck here. That does damages and things. So let's look at all the Ruby cards. Let's look at Ruby. I wish there was a way to filter to only actions. No, stop it. VP/VK. We have Crackling Bolts and Burns killed them with the Yotul activation, Ian. This does 4 with the Yotul activation. Burning Tendrils does 4 with the Yotul activation. I think if we were going to try Nightmares, I would have to cut Cleaves. I think 12. One of the big issues with that other build, we had 14 threes in it, I think, and that was way too many threes. Rage Fire's probably not unplayable. Oh, you know what I wanted to try? I wonder if Impulse is playable. Yeah. I played this card in the Benvolio burn deck and was always pretty happy with it. Yeah, Boris, but you have to remember, too, is that I think a lot of people write off decks like this as being easy to play, and they're sloppy and makes mistakes with it and miss points of damage. Like, I can't tell you the number of times, you know, I've seen people play decks like this, and, you know, they, like, their opponent stabilizes at one or two, and they miss one or two points of damage. This deck's super cheap. Chord for 5. Are you related to Chord for 4? Chord for 4 is a sub. I don't want another 3 drop. Although I guess this is like a pseudo 3 drop. Check out this link. For some cheap decks. You have any questions, feel free to ask. I think Rage Fire is like the only real option as an additional burn spell. We could play like a couple burn to the ground. I think I just want these impulses. I think I'm gonna give this a try. I guess I also just wouldn't even hate like main deck Ember Spire Witches. This card seems super reasonable. Does anyone hate that? Do we hate just, like, main deck Ember Spire Witch? Like, the Swift Strike's okay. The Can't Gain Life is okay. What are the... I guess this isn't very good against the popular decks right now, right? Like, the Boris deck isn't gaining life gain 1. McBombus isn't gaining life gain 1. So I guess that's not true. Cleave's a solid medium. I wonder if I want more Kiss than Cleave. I'm gonna do that. I'm going to swap this. I'm going to do a 2-3 in the other direction, I think. I'm going to put a cleave in the reserves and put the third kiss in the main. Was I pretty happy with the shard base? We had 4. Yeah, I don't really think we had issues getting to our colors, right? I think the Lixil deck is super clunky on average, though. Like that last matchup, like we beat him in 2, technically. I think the one Cross Ridge Rubble seemed fine. We had a couple times where we couldn't use it, but it also gave rage once and it fixed a couple of times. So we've got 4, 8, 9, 13 blood sources with the infusion devices. And we've only got all of our blood things are just in the 3 slot. And try the Darkspire Orc that does 3. Huh. I don't hate that, actually. I kind of really like that, actually. We could play... Maybe I want 4 of that card, actually. Huh. What do we think of that? We could play more Orc Shards, then? Oh, I have troops filtered off tonight. Let's reset. What do we think of these? If I get up to 12 orcs, I could probably play. I could probably play 2 or 3 orc shards. Let's try it, right? At least, what's 500 platinum? The deck just 5x, so it can pay for itself. Concuss. I don't love this. I mean, so this is a 3 that kind of relies on chance, but, like, if you don't hit the 3 damage side, you hit the get another Darkspire out of your deck side. I think I want to try this. We're down double red cards too, right? The only double red card is burning tendrils at the top end now. Yeah. Maybe I cut the cleaves. I think cleaves only good matches were probably already pretty good. I don't know if I want all 4 Quashra Dribbles. So yeah, so this card, so for people that aren't familiar with this card that we're talking about that may or may not be good, this is a 2-1 for 2 that when it dies, you flip a coin basically, and either it does 3 damage to your opponent, or you search your deck for another Darkspire. So basically it replaces itself, or it does 3 damage to them when it dies. What's the... Let's... So... Hyper geometric distribution. So this is what I... When I decide on whether or not I want to... This is a hypergeometric distribution calculator for those that have never used this before. Basically, our population side, we have 60 cards in our deck, a number of successes in the population. So we have 12 orcs in the deck. An orc is what we're considering a success. We want to know what's our chance of having an orc by turn 2 on the play. So that would, we'd see 8 cards by turn 2 on the play, and we want at least 1 orc in those cards. So we calculate the probability. And with 12 orcs, there's an 85% chance that we would have an orc by turn 2 on the play. So I think that's high enough. I think 85% is pretty good, right? And like if we go to 9 here, by turn 2 on the draw, we're 88%. By turn 3 on the draw, it's pretty likely. Maybe I just want 3 of them. We probably don't need all that much fixing. 3's probably fine. So that's 3, 6, 10, 14. I did not get a chance to see how surprised he was. Link to the... This is... You can just Google hypergeometric distribution calculator. This is the one I like because it's super clean and doesn't have a bunch of ads on it. Wouldn't your sample be less because one of those cards would be the shard? Yeah, technically, it's approximate. There's a lot of different things that go into the calculation, but that's like a really crude, rough estimate what I did there. Tormentor. Unmerciful Tormentor? Nah, we just want cards that deal damage to them directly. That's the reason why. The reason why all of these troops are acceptable, like Arena Regular can do damage without ever attacking. This can do damage without ever having connected. This does damage without ever having connected. That's why these cards are good. Like, we just want a bunch of cards that are reach, essentially. Yeah, Quashridge, the one-drop-based aggressive decks got much worse with the introduction of Transmog. Is basically what happened. Transmog pushed the one-drop aggressive decks almost completely out of the format. All right. So I already joined another gauntlet. Let's run it. Let's run it. Deck feels sweet. Deck's definitely powerful. Does sweet things. Well, that's awesome. I'm always happy to help people. Ooh, Neo. Kinda. It's always nice. I always like taking a break to play decks like this one or like the elf deck that I played for a little while. Just like, especially when I'm like spending so much time like grinding like the Blood Sapphire control deck and other things like that. Just like take a break and set people on fire. Always feels good. Seems reasonable. It's got again, the one thing we're really looking for in opening hands is not too many shards and a consistent source of damage, which Ebony Pawn is. It's not bad. I'm gonna play this out, grab a ruby. What is he doing that he's just, like, milling me for no value there? That's something. He doesn't have any prophecies in his deck yet, so I'm just going to go ahead and play out my Ebony Pawn here to start. I don't need to burn this right away. And honestly, we probably don't even really care about him doubling up his prophecies all that much because we're just going to, like, be aggressive and kill him. Opponent starting with 24 is a big deal, though. Yeah. Let me get you a link. This is... Now we do kind of want to draw a shard that makes a temporary resource so we can arena regular plus burn this. Another arena regular. You know, the fact that I didn't make blood on one is kind of punishing us. Neo says there's no way he could win. Yeah, probably not. I think this matchup's probably very bad for him. I'm not even going to kill this Starcaller Ancient. It's so bad for him. Yeah, I missed a point of damage here because I really should have activated my champion power this turn, I think. We had been talking about this champion being good against the other prophecy decks. Like, your opponent casts Lanupa's Sight and you just, like, activate Nin and discard the top two cards of their deck. No blocks. Honestly, we're probably just not even going to touch this. God, he's so dead. He's so dead. All right, how much damage can we do this turn? A lot, right? Oh, jeez. So I just, like, activate my champion power, burning tendrils, this, hit him. Yeah, I think that's what we do. Got a transmog. Alright, we got a giant cocoon. Sure. Sweet. Man, if we would hit a shard last turn, he'd have taken so much damage. So he has another free transmog that draws a card. Because this thing's doubling his stuff. So this isn't going to do much right now. This deck, the deck that I'm playing, is very, 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 very cheap monetary-wise. I think I'm playing the Infusion Device. The Arena Regular just doesn't do anything because my opponent has a Transmog in their hand. Do I want to activate this turn? I don't think I do. I think I want to just activate Ebony Pawn and then Crackling Bolt my opponent, and then next turn we can just, like, activate this and triple burn him. I did not explicitly reach the season two goal, so I decided to just, like, take the donation thing down, because, what was I gonna say? We're mostly doing Hex streams. It seemed weird to ask for money to go to Magic events on a Hex stream. Maybe I'll put it up there when we're streaming live Magic on Wednesdays. Block. There are cards that reduce your opponent's shards in Hex, but they don't reduce their threshold. So basically you can't color screw people while destroying their resources. Alright, and then if he doesn't have counter magic in his hand, he's actually dead here. And he's probably dead even with counter magic. He'd have to have a lot of counter magics. All right, he's at 5. And this is 4 damage here. So if we draw a shard, we kill him because we activate our champion power. Ooh, a 2-1. That flies. Local in Las Vegas, a $10 donation. Thanks, mate. I appreciate it. Look at that. He milled 2 non-shards. How nice of him. How nice of him. I really do appreciate that, mate. I bought a plane ticket to Wooster after my good finishes this past weekend. Or the past 2 weekends. So I'm excited for that. Game's actually pretty close. Shard? There we go. Tick, tick, boom! Tick, tick, boom! Even got these arena regulars in my hand that aren't doing nothing. For you, to you. Dead. Got him. Alright, so how are we boarding? Mindspire doesn't seem awful. Just like a good consistent damage source. He's drawing a lot of cards, probably. I think I actually want to board down on troops. Is that real? That might be real. Darkspire Priestess does not seem good against someone whose primary source of removal is Transmogrified. Cleave doesn't seem awful against all of his idiots. I don't think he's going to have life gain. He's mono Sapphire. Kiss seems fairly medium. Kiss might be better than Arena Regulars, because like that last game we saw, Arena Regulars got really awkward in our hand. I guess this probably does some damage the turn it comes down. Let's just split the difference and go 3-3 here. I also don't want to board out too many orcs since we're on 3 orc shards now. I'm gonna go ahead and save this. I might bring the Darkspires back in on the play. Like your troops are better on the play than on the draw for sure. This is actually pretty resource hungry, so this is a fairly easy mulligan. Went to 5, sweet. Is this a mulligan? Yeah, I'm gonna be. We've won off 5 cards several times. I'm gonna keep this one. This one's got a Ghostfire Duelist. This has got a bunch of consistent damage sources, so I need to run off a shard or two, but hand's good otherwise. Ding! Never didn't have it. Free extra activation with Arena Regular. Yeah, maybe. It's very possible, especially now that we've cut the Pyretic Performers were, we had 7 double ruby cards instead of just the 3. I guess Mind Pyres. I'm such a professional. It's possible we're supposed to Arena Regular there instead of this because he's holding up Verdict, but, like, this turn he's holding up Counter Magic. I also kind of want to just jam this on 3. I got a coin, sure. If he doesn't have... I could play the Arena Regular and then a Shard here, but I really want to just get the Mind Pyre in under Counter Magic here, so he has to have another Verdict this turn. Otherwise, this card's probably going to end the game. It's just, yeah, that sucks. Okay. I still think that's the right line. Like, make him have it. He mulliganed to 5, and he had a very good 5. Yep, would have been real good. Alright, so let's play Arena Regular here. And then play Blood Infusion Device, which will do a damage to my opponent because of Arena Regular. And then, I think I'm actually going to hold this shard till next turn, because next turn I can activate my champion ability and play this, activate this, burn him. We only get punished for doing this if he draws another transmog or removal spell. Indigo Dreamwalker, sure. I love how he's just, like, randomly billing me. His champion activation doesn't seem to do anything this matchup. I'm pretty sure he's playing Nin just to beat the Prophecy decks. Alright, so we activate my champion ability, which increases all non-combat damage I deal by 1 this turn. So this Arena Regular does 2, which is great. And he also gained Rage from that shard, which is wonderful. Oh! Oh, poop. Oh, I'm a big dumb stupid. I was counting on being able to use this. I forgot it takes double blood threshold, and I had the shard and could have. Whoops. That's unfortunate. Okay. That's really unfortunate. So, completely my mistake. Hopefully that doesn't bite us. God, how good would that Mind Spire have been? So good! It would have been so good! Alright, so activate this. And I think we're just supposed to be burning him out here. So let's just do this. Does 6, I believe. Does 4 plus 2. Does 4 from that. Yeah, and then play a shard. Put him down to 9. So he'd be at 5 right now if I had taken the blood threshold instead of giving this rage. Which again, big mistake on my part. I need to draw pretty okay here to win this game. Alright, neither of those. The blood infusion device would have been nuts, actually. Which was the top card of our deck. Probably would have won the game with that. I think this deck's very good. I know someone else that a lot of people aren't having success with it, but I also think a lot of newer players are playing this type of deck because it's cheap. This is an attack for just that much, okay. Well, Blood Shard kills him, right? Blood Infusion Device also kills him. Alright. That should be... No, I'm one short. Yeah, I'm one short. This puts him to one. We go to 11 though, right? Then we're not dead on board. Okay. Oh, not dead on board. 3, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Got two blockers. All right. So you just need one of these to live and to draw a shard next turn. Well, milled a shard. No blocks. So shard kills him. Not a shard. Alright. Do I want... I think I want the Darkspire on the play. Kiss doesn't seem great. Arena Regular was good. I think I want the troops on the play. Tendril seems good. Cleave seems good. All these cards seem good. Burns medium, maybe? Let's try this. This could be wrong. Play first. Yeah, sounds great. Sounds really good, actually, right? Turn one Ghostfire. Do you want to go turn one Ghostfire or turn two Arena Regular? I think I want to go Ghostfire on one. Make him have the transmog. And hopefully if he transmogs us into the, we'll get really lucky and get the one that is a Mox. Sweet, no transmog. Shard that makes a temporary resource. God, I'm so good at this. Neo didn't concede, I conceded. I was dead. Opponent, he was, we were dead on board. Wow, we had the transmog and was saving it. Okay. God, there are so many scary one drops we could have gotten there, too. Very lucky. So now this only does one to him. Do another one. That's unfortunate. Maybe I'm supposed to attack first there. Yeah, I'm probably supposed to attack first there. He probably transmogs when we attack anyways, but I think it's correct to attack first. Yeah, man, you got a Thunderfield Elder. You do you. You know what? Because I have these Crackling Bolts in my hand, maybe I was supposed to activate this last turn? It's close. So let's activate this. Do one. Give a random Orc Rage and do two. Oh, this did two, sorry. And then each of these do six. So that does six to him, four and two. Do I want to Crackling Bolt this? If I Crackling Bolt this, it does four here, and then we get in for three. That seems worse than just doing four to him. Yeah, I'm just going to do another six to him. The Crackling Bolt Yotul Arena regular is just like, it's so nuts. So he'd have died this turn if he hadn't had the transmog for this. Or if this had just, like, transformed into something scary. Alright, so we're putting him to one this turn. And we can draw any card that deals damage directly to kill him. Yep, that'll do it. That'll do, pig! So this does two, this does two, this does two. Alright! 1-0 start to this gauntlet. Let's keep lighting him up! Light him up! We on fire! I think there's a lot of people. I think there's a lot of people right now that fall into the category like Neo last game where he just like, you know, told his stream that I just can't win. And I've definitely played a bunch of decks that just like this deck shows up on the other side of the table and you're just like, well, that was nice. This is one of our losses. This deck probably doesn't beat the Wild Diamond deck, but that's about it. Okay, we're going to be off to the races it looks like here. Let's see if he's got the rabbit or not. Sweet, no rabbit, probably dead then. Boris, you have a sub. Did you just sub today, Boris? You have it. I don't remember seeing one pop up. Is there a chance you put it through when my stream died? If that happened, I apologize. There's probably a non-zero chance you put it through when my stream died. My toddler hit the suspend button on my computer that I wasn't aware existed. Yeah, man, you got a brown fox scout. Boris, are you Boris Blastforge? Are you the Boris Blastforge? If he holds up counter magic here, I don't think I want to play Crackling Bolt into it. I think I'll play the Dark Spire out and transmog one of my guys. Sure. Look at that. We got the one that gives us a resource. Thanks, bud. I agree with transmogging there. It seems fine. Do I want a Dark Spire or do I want a Crackling Bolt? I'm going to activate this either way. Yeah, and the sub notification was down, and I didn't have chat open either when I got the computer back online, because I lost a game due to the computer being disconnected, because toddlers. All right, I think I'm just going to jam the Dark Spire. Yeah, let's just jam the Dark Spire. If you want to counter magic this, you can counter magic it. I think I want to activate Forge and burn his dome here too while we've got the Yotul activation going. The fact that this and the infusion device give charges is so good. Whiskey Dingo, make sure you, and actually this is a good note for everyone, I'm going to be streaming Paper Magic once a week starting next week to fill some of that void. We're also going to have my last MTGO stream that'll also involve some Hex. Check this out. Make sure you do that. So opponent's going to 13 here. And then if he doesn't have more counter magic, we can do 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 next turn down to 5. And he's only got 3 power on the board. So we're in a pretty good spot here. We've got some draws. Even if we don't, even if we just like draw shards the rest of the game, we're in an okay spot because that means we're going to be activating Yotul. He's killing one of my guys. Okay. You're taking 4 here. So on a 4 turn clock. I am actually planning to sell off all of my stuff after my Magic Online stream. I'm not going to do it live because like I have to sort through what I have borrowed from Card Hoarder and what I still own, but it will involve that. Puts him to 5. This puts him to 3, and then he's dead to anything that does damage next turn. He's even just dead in 2 cycles from this Ghostfire Duelist. Alright, so he needs a removal spell for this Duelist. He's dead, and even if he has the removal spell for the duelist, we get a life draw next turn. Alright, how are we boarding this matchup? That's a real good question. The heat waves, I think all the sweeps come in, right? The heat waves and the electrofry and the cleaves probably come in too. What's not great? My gut says the arena regulars aren't great. I can see that being incorrect. Whirling Brutalizer. I guess what I think is going to do more on average, the Arena Regular or the Whirling Brutalizer. I guess he doesn't have a ton of removal, and the Whirling Brutalizer gets blocked, and we're bringing in some more expensive cards anyway, so maybe I'm supposed to cut these. I think I like that logic. Vampire Kits is also kind of expensive, and we don't really need a ton of life gain. Yeah, Loco, honestly, like, I think we're all just, like, okay, so here's the real truth. If any of you that have played Magic for a long time, if you've followed Magic coverage, when Kibler freaked out, and if Kibler stopping streaming and writing his big giant post about it didn't get anything fixed, nothing's going to get it done, which is really sad. But, you know, thankfully Hex is great, and the software is great, and I have that to stream now. Speaking of, it looks like we've got a little under 100 people hanging out here this afternoon. I'd like to say thank you to everyone for choosing to spend part of your Friday afternoon here with us. Now, there's a lot of different things you could be doing, different people you could be watching, so thanks for choosing to spend part of your day here. Second chart's not great. What are the odds he doesn't have it 2 games in a row? Probably gonna get Runeer this turn. Ghostfire Duelist is a little awkward with Heatwave. Ooh, that shard comes into play tapped. Got him. Doesn't offer the trade. Interesting. Now that's a tough choice. Yeah, definitely. Do I want to play out the second Ghostfire Duelist, Ghostblade Duelist? I think I do. I think I just want to use my resources. I think I'm just going to go boop boop. I don't even know if the Heat Waves are good, in all honesty. Like, Heat Wave might not even be good in this deck. Like, I didn't have it in my original build, and, like, turn two Hierophant on the draw felt bad, but, like, in all honesty, a lot of times with decks like this, boarding in, it's like, so if you've ever played Modern Burn in Magic, like, boarding in Path to Exile in that deck, there's a lot of really good burn players that just, like, don't think you should be playing Path to Exile, because it just doesn't deal damage to your opponent, and you're gonna have a lot of games where you draw it, and you're just like, oh, if this was just a thing that did some damage to you, you'd die. Like, if he Hyros here, I'm gonna, like, want a Heat Wave, and then I'm gonna lose my Ghostfire Duelist. Transmog, sure, okay, no Hyro is good. Alright, sweet, Ebony Pawn. So what am I doing here? Let's think about this. Definitely playing this to start. Activating Yotul? I'm probably activating Yotul. I've got a bunch of charges. Hey, Mort. Thanks for hanging out. So if I activate this, I'm definitely activating this. So let's get that in and do two with this Duelist. Then the question is, am I playing Burning Tendrils or am I casting Ebony Pawn? I kind of want to cast Ebony Pawn because it gets in two this turn, and the next turn we activate this and then do Burning Tendrils plus this. So I think I like that. I think getting the Ebony Pawn into play, we might be getting Verdict of the Ancient Kings tier regardless of what we're playing, and I think I'd rather get this Verdicted too. Getting the Ebony Pawn into play now means over the course of the next two turns, this does 4 damage as opposed to just doing 2 damage if we were to play it next turn. And the Tendrils is still going to do the damage it does next turn that it did this turn. So I think the upside is playing the Ebony Pawn here. It's a little less resource efficient, but I don't know if we're worried about being resource efficient at this current point in time. Yeah, that's exactly it. The recurring damage source needs to get into play quicker. So let's activate this and do boop, boop. Honestly, do I want a Heat Wave? Nah, let's wait a turn. I think this is getting counter magicked. Okay, he had the Verdict and thought about it on the Ebony Pawn. Okay. So next turn, we're going to go Shard, Yotul Activation, Ghostfire, Boop, Infusion Device, Heatwave. I think Hex is going to learn from a lot of Magic's design mistakes and not print stupid cards like that. Play another troop that Heatwave kills. Rats. That's not great. So let's activate this. Activate this. At least this gains us some life, so we're not dead next turn. Cast Heat Wave. Wow, that was excellent. Everything's going better than expected. Put you to 6. Put you to 4. Pass the turn. If he doesn't have a Brown Fox out here, we're in a great spot. Okay. He's dead in 4. Actually, he's dead in less than 4, right? Because our cards... we're dead in 2. All right. Come on, Crackling Bolt. Burning Tendrils. All right. He's dead next turn. Rawr. Rawr. Blame a Shard. Your move, Yugi boy. It was basically Pyroclasm. Yep. 2 damage to each troop. Yeah! Alrighty. Got the finger guns at the ready. All right, I'm going to run a quick commercial, and then we will light some more people on fire. This deck's great. Ah. the secret to life is relax and pew pew people occasionally. If you only play Blood Sapphire Control all the time, you'll go insane. Just gotta sit back, relax, and play your arena regulars. Are there any? I don't think there's any rares in this deck, right? Like just Heat Wave? All right, looks like the commercial's done. Thanks everyone that doesn't ad block and doesn't sub sitting through that. Mulligan to four. Yep, we're gonna keep this hand. These actually aren't great without a pawn or a ghost fire, but they're fine against someone who went to four. There. Pass the turn. I don't know if I just want a shotgun upstairs on turn one. That's probably what I'm supposed to do. I'm just going to respond to this. Send a message. That's what this game sends the message. We know what this game is about, you and I. It's about that burn spell hitting you in the face. Is this a rare? No, this is an uncommon. Brutalizer is an uncommon. He mulled to four, okay? That's lower than five. Yeah, I'm just gonna activate this and crackling bolt him for four. Our ideal draw would have been a pawn that turn. I mean, if he casts sight here, he's gonna catch back up in cards really quick. Like, you know, three cost draw three is not the worst. He said, all things considered, his mulligan's not that bad. Yeah, gray, green, blue, red. Red is their mythic. Yep, their sight. So, we have a game, as the kids say. That would have been good to see last turn. I'm going to play this. I'm assuming he's blocking the Brutalizer. What's the AA Brutalizer look like? Can anyone link me a picture? Because this chick is ugly. Ugly. Apologize to anyone that thinks she's pretty, but she is. I mean, it's an orc. I'm assuming she's supposed to be ugly by default. That's by design, one would assume. So I guess if we would have saved a burn for this turn, we would be doing an extra 3 damage with this, so maybe I'm supposed to have saved that. Also not particularly pretty. I guess orcs are, like I said, orcs are probably not supposed to be pretty. I'm going to try and save this Brutalizer to a turn where it can push some damage through. We might actually lose this game, because like I said, my hand was not good. I don't, maybe we're just supposed to have a hard, fast rule where we don't keep a hand that doesn't have a 7 that doesn't have a consistent damage source in it. The hands with consistent damage sources are what we're definitely looking for. Crackling Bolt us. Message received. More Orkin for the Porkin, yep. She's a big gal. Oh right, there's like an orc love story in the WoW movie, right? Well, that our medium 7 has not been helped by the fact that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I guess we've drawn 2 spells and however many draws. Yeah, I'm just gonna ship up my priestess here. Assuming he's trading. And get your licks in now. Alright, take three. Sweet. So next turn, we will Kiss plus Brutalizer with a Yotul activation. It might be that I have enough resources here that I'm just supposed to have activated Yotul last turn in case I hit this activation and puts him to 12 that way. If he doesn't have a burn, we're in a great spot. If he has a burn, it's going to be kind of a close game. He's going to have a Thunderfield Elder too. That's pretty good as well. He's going to have to trade with the Whirling Brutalizer. We'll give it Rage just to encourage him to trade with it. Gaining three buys us some time, which is nice. Cleave's pretty good in this matchup. That's why I left two in the reserves. Alright, no burn. Good. Down to seven. Trades here. Yeah, so there's no way you don't trade there. If this card in our hand wasn't a shard, we'd be in a good spot. I guess we could just like run off Crackling Bolt in the burn here. He doesn't have any counter magic in his main deck. He has Rage Fire just once already, though, so... And the lesson this game is that 7 was not a keep. Win or lose, that 7 was not a keep. I guess that's fair. Maybe I'm supposed to kill that. We get less damage overall that way, right? So if we would have Crackling Bolted his thing, the orc wouldn't have gotten its trigger, so when Whirling Brutalizer attacks, it only does damage to my opponent if they've already taken damage that turn. We're dead to Rage Fire here. It's unfortunate. We got a bunch of draws that kill him, though. That is not one of them. Burning Tendrils killed our opponent there. Crackling Bolt, Burn, Blood Infusion Device... Still only dead to Rage Fire, not dead to Crackling Bolt yet. Dead to Crackling Bolt next turn. Opponent's dead to Vampire Kiss, too. Nah, the Prophecy Burn's quickly becoming the norm. Alright, might get some dead. It was a close game. Our draw was pretty poor, and he mulliganed, so... He mulliganed, and then we had a bad opener. Bad opener that did not draw out of it. He just typed in chat, want some poetic justice? He goes, I've got two phoenixes stuck in my hand right now. Which is a card that I've been very adamant should not be in his deck. That's too funny. That's too good. Okay. Alright, kisses in. Cleaves in. What do I want to cut? I think Brutalizer is just like my go-to cut. I just don't want a bunch of threes in my deck. Brutalizer might be better than Darkspire Priestess. I don't know, it's close. I think I'm gonna leave Darkspire Priestess in, because I like Darkspire Priestess lets us trade off and be a little bit defensive, especially on the draw. Do you want Mindspire? Yeah, I probably want the Mindspire against the deck that draws cards, right? At least one of them. Yeah, I'm just going to bring in one on the draw. It's a little slow. Maybe we'll bring in a second on the play. Sand's medium. It's got a consistent damage source in it and other good spells, though, so we're going to keep it. It's a low resource count to start. I guess it does have a lot of threes in it, so it does need to hit another resource to be good, but... Ebony Pawn's great. Second consistent damage source. And we'll probably actually play the Ebony Pawn next turn, since it can't just get hit by a removal spell, and it does damage right away. There were a lot of the lists were only playing two and three copies of this card. I looked at more of them last night, and this card's so good. He's got Verdict of the Ancient Kings post-reserves, which is something we do have to think about. Now that I drew the Blood Infusion device, I kind of want to go boop boop. I feel like he's likely to play a 3-drop next turn. I want to make sure this Ebony Pawn resolves. And this could just eat a burn, and like he might not have the Verdict, but I feel like if he doesn't have a play on 3, we're probably winning the game anyways. And if he does have a play on 3, then Ebony Pawn gets to stick. Yep. So again, threat assessment is really important in matchups like this and with decks like the one I'm playing. You want to prioritize which threats you're forcing through to resolve and which ones you aren't. Can't play the Burning Tendrils yet because we need an additional Ruby Threshold. But not mine some shards. Look at that. Just a pure professional. Now we have a choice. Ebony Pawn starts pushing consistent damage, but the Cleave is guaranteed to resolve this turn. I guess I could be greedy with the Cleave and wait until it can hit one more thing. Do I want to activate this as a choice? I don't think I want to activate that yet, though. I think we're still pretty far off. I kind of want to make sure we have activations when we do Vampiric Kiss and Cleave. Probably don't want to use this to just get one damage. Want to use this to get, like, 2 to 3 points of damage. So, Yotul, for people that aren't aware, Yotul says non-combat damage by your card is increased by 1 damage this turn. So, basically, increases Ebony Pawn to 2. It increases Cleave to do 2 damage to 3 targets. It makes Burning Tendrils do 4 to their troop and 3 to them. It makes Vampire Kiss do 3. Hopefully he plays a Thunderfield Elder here. If I can cleave them all up. Probably. Yeah, good. God bless him. We know he's not ghosting. He's a sub. He wouldn't be ghosting anyways. But yeah, it's nice to have a little confirmation. Cleave them up. Right, down to 17, and we have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 points just between our hand and the board already, not counting the damage Ebony Pawn's going to push out over the next few turns. Crackling Bolt me, sure. Next turn, we're going to go ahead and... Ooh, he's debating whether or not he wants to attack because of Whirling Brutalizer. That's sweet. Huh. I think I'm going to activate this. Yeah, so I'm going to activate this. I'm going to kiss him, Blood Infusion Device, and then Ebony Pawn. And the reason why I'm doing the kiss now is I want to make sure this resolves because it's probably going to buy us an entire extra turn. And putting the Blood Infusion device on the table, these are damages in the bank that he's not going to be able to interact with, most likely. Unless he's got some kind of artifact destruction added to the reserves. But there aren't a lot of artifacts in the format right now, so he's probably doesn't have any. So now we've got... Excuse me. Ooh, that was gross. Each of these does 3 damage, and then this does 3, and... Oof. Would not mind another shard next turn. Just do this plus this, and then this. Running shards even let us curve into empowering this at some point. You play this, copy it. Okay, yep. So there's some damages. Probably going to need to activate one of these next turn to buffer our life total a little bit here. Probably attacking with both now, so I didn't have the Brutalizer last turn. Not likely to have it this turn. That's not the shirt I asked for Christmas. I'm gonna go ahead and activate this. That lets this blood infusion device drain for 4. Let's ebony pawn hit for 2. Really just trying to avoid playing into his counter magic at this point, because he definitely has verdicts and counter magic post reserves. Yep, crackling bolt us. Okay, Phoenix, are we dead? Nope, this puts us to 4. So shard kills him? Shard that makes a temporary resource kills him. No, any shard kills him, right? Yeah, any shard kills him. That is not any shard. That's unfortunate. So we can only do... Hey, Neo with the host. Welcome, everyone. We're still lighting people on fire this afternoon. Infusion device puts me to... So if we would have hit a shard there, we would have gone shard, crackling bolt you for 3, activate my champion power, do 2, and then he'd die. So he's got 6 power on the board now. So we're going to be dead to any burn spell here, but we do have to cash this in because we're just dead on board right now. Dying with this many cards in our hand in the burn deck feels real bad. Ooh, I drew a lot of cards. Dead to Rage Fire, Crackling Bolt, burn here. So, am I dead, Jim? Don't toy with my emotions! Don't do it! Don't do it! Why your roll so slow? Pass the turn! Pass the turn! Oh, no! He was, in fact, rolling slowly. It's unfortunate. Yeah, I think I'm happy with how we're configured. We were 1 turn off there. We were a shard off of killing him. I think this is fine. Just go ahead and save. I watched you get your butt kicked by this really bad burn deck, Neo. That's really budget burn deck. Some noob was playing it. Hue. Someone asking about the card. Yeah, we're going to try it in core, and we're going to try it in things that aren't core. We're just going to try it in all the stuff. This hand's meh. It's probably fine. Darkspire on 2. Yeah, I'm going to keep this. It's got Darkspire on 2. A lot closer than we both thought it would be, sure. Well, that was not what we wanted to see. This matchup is definitely close. I think the Yotul deck's a little bit ahead, but this matchup overall is probably pretty close. The McBombus deck just really doesn't have terribly hard matchups. More Thunderfields. going to go ahead and activate my champion power here, just in case this Darkspire dies. I'd rather it deal 4. And if it doesn't die, we're still going to probably burn his face this turn, so... Wow, no blocks. Okay. Yeah, I'm just going to go 7 you then if you don't block the Darkspire. Maybe you're just hoping to blank my activation there. Yeah, well, this card's dealt 2 damage, and if it does its trigger, it'll do at least 5 damage. So this was a 2-cost deal 5, so that seems fine. Probably going to Rage Fire Crackling Bolt this. He's got 2 draws in the bank from these Thunderfield Seers. Yep, did 3 to my opponent. So again, that was a 2-cost deal 5. If we run some non-shards off here, we're in an okay spot. This is 3 to my opponent, putting them in a virtual 7. Should be an attack with everything, yeah. That's not what the doctor ordered. I'm just going to blow this now. We could wait to empower it because we're guaranteed going to hit 6, but if we don't draw anything to do over the next few turns, we're just going to lose the game anyways, so might as well just run it out. He said, I didn't mean to click through that block, and he said he's got a small child with him. We're up to 150 because Neo signed off and gave us the host because he's the best. I appreciate that. So just like casual 6 cards. Man, if these 2 cards dealt damage, he'd be quaking. He's probably a little worried as is just because, like, statistically speaking, these 2 cards probably do damage. But they don't. I mean, they kind of do damage with the Yotul activation, but not really. I don't think I want to jam the Kiss this turn. I think I want to wait until I have 2 cards to play out so my Yotul activation can do +2. Boom, sacrifice a troop, deal 1 damage, born to die. That was a good draw. Huh. I'm going to activate this and Vampire Kiss him. They think there's a good chance he counters this. Nope. Okay. Yeah, I'm just going to hold this for now. Really don't want to play this into a counterspell. Rage Fire me, sure. Okay. Oh, we need a shard now to kill the Phoenix with this. That's unfortunate. Hey, Tom. Thanks for the resub. I appreciate it, mate. Welcome. Welcome back. Look at that. Put those 6 shards to good use. Thanks for the continued support, mate. God, we're just lining them up and knocking them down today, huh? The third win? All right. At least one more. We're gonna play till at least until we lose, maybe till we finish the gauntlet. This deck churns out games quick, too. Uptime of the Ring of Fire Sog, right? And it burns, burns, burns. That burning Ring of Fire. Ooh, 17 health opponent. Don't mind if I does. We's on the play? Oh, baby. Oh, baby. Oh, baby, baby. Sand's great. Can kill, can bolt the bird, as the kids say. Did you have a verdict in your hand at the end there, Dace? Or Ace? Dace, it's Hollowed Ace. I thought it was always Hollow Dace, and I definitely, your capitalization on Hex made me realize I'd been looking at it wrong. Hey, Jake. What are you wearing, Jake, from State Farm? No, it doesn't. The most expensive cards in this deck are the Ember Spire Witches and the Heat Waves and the Reserves. You probably don't need the Heat Waves for the deck to be playable, but you definitely need the Ember Spire Witches. Yep, I'm just going to play my Arena Regular out. This is a pretty split. What are we supposed to do with our 2-drop here? It's an easier choice if we already had another Shard. I think it's definitely the Arena Regular if we had another Shard in hand, but without having another Shard, I think it's pretty close. Shard, Shard, Shard. That's unfortunate. If we hit Shard here, I would go Arena Regular, activate Shard, burn this. I'm going to offer the trade here. I don't think he's going to take it. And if he does take it, I think I'm okay with that. Okay, I was wrong. There's no Zygomatz games on the board. I don't think game's very good. I don't even know if the Heat Waves are good, in all honesty. Just like... Come on, Shard. Come on, dealer. Daddy needs a new pair of Shards. Shard! Shard! That's not a Shard. Okay, it gives us a charge, though. So I can go activate this, play my Blood Infusion device, deal 2 to you from Arena Regular, burn this, it does 3 because of my Yotul activation, crack you for 2 with my regular. Okay, okay, we're cooking with gas, as the kids say. The kids probably don't say, I say that, I'm cooking with gas. This deck isn't quite big red rail people into the ground, but it's a close second. It's a good time. I don't think game is good in this deck. That's a good point. I don't think game is good in this deck. Alright, there's a Shard, so let's play this. And do a damage to my opponent from this. I think I just want a Burning Tendrils this Stork. It really sucks having all these pawns in my hand that I haven't played out yet. Some propane and some propane accessories. No! Why do your shards gain you life? That's not even fair. That's not even fair. How am I supposed to keep up if you gain 3? I don't think I've lost to Boris yet while playing this deck, so like, again, sample size is huge there. So he doesn't have another threat to play? Why wouldn't you attack with this if you have a Croc to play? Alright, teach their own. Shard. Alright, what are we doing here? What are we doing indeed? I think it's just Ebony Pawn hits you for 1 pass. That doesn't feel good. I almost wonder if we want... So someone mentioned Crackling Vortex as a possibility. I almost want a 23rd Shard in this deck. We've been losing way more games to stumbling on Shards than we have been to having too many. I agree, Immortals. They should definitely be playing them. I just, you know, as a burn player, I'm going to complain about it. Yeah, I definitely feel like I want another shard in this deck, and Crackling Vortex seems like a good choice for adding a shard. There you go. Now sit up here with Dad. Video's unavailable. What's with that? All right, Dad's gonna put it on the TV for you, okay? Tablet's messed up. Oh, sorry for the brief moment. Toddler calls. You wanna see some Caillou? Dad. What do you mean there's no Caillou? Netflix, come on, don't screw with me. Life gain is cheating. Alright, well, I'm gonna have to have a look at that later. Apparently Caillou and Daniel Tiger got pulled off of Netflix. Or my phone's just not seeing them right now. That's annoying. Those are our favorites, right? Caillou and Daniel Tiger? Yeah, I would definitely side in verdicts against me, Holidays. Definitely. That's going to be really sad if the PBS shows are gone. Like, that's a big part of what we pay for Netflix for. And it wouldn't play from the tablet either, so maybe... Thomas is still there, so we got that going for us. Alright, so if we hit a shard next turn... If we hit a shard next turn, we can do 10 to him. Which is probably a little... not enough. I don't know, it depends on what else is still in his hand. We're probably losing this game. We missed a fourth shard for a little bit too long. And again, I think we want a 23rd shard to mitigate games like this that happened. Like, even the game where we hit our sixth shard against Holidays, we ended up winning that. No play? Yeah, game killing pawns is really good. Shard next turn is 12. Oh, right, with the arena regular, right. Yeah, you're right. You're right, he's dead. I'm an idiot. We good, we got it, fam. We figured it out. Alright, so Arena Regular does 2 because the shard gives us a charge. Ebony Pawn does 2 from that. Ebony Pawn does 2, and then Crackling Bolt does 6. Crackling Bolt doing 6 off of the Yotul activation and the Arena Regular is so gross. Alright, so what are we doing here against Cressida? Cleave seems okay in this matchup. I don't think I want Heat Wave. Electrofry could be okay. I think I want the one of those. Whirling Brutalizer's probably never connecting on the ground. He's probably bringing in Life Gain out of the board, right? Bringing at least one Ember Spire, which I think. Let's try this. 12 to dead. That's a big chunk of life. Mazavith, great stream. I'm enjoying getting into Hex. It's a refreshing change. Awesome. I'm glad to have you back, and I'm glad you're enjoying Hex as well. And if you didn't hear from my Magic content, we're going to be doing live paper Magic streams every week. So if you're looking for Magic content too, we're still going to have that. Check that out. If you are into Hex, we're going to be doing Hex during the long stream. And there's stuff in there that's just relevant to all subs. So welcome. Welcome back, resub hype. Hype. I could see more Ember Spire, which is coming. We don't know how many life gain downloads he's going to have out of the reserves, so we'll have to wait and see. If he has more... The thing that I really don't like Ember Spire Witch against the Carnosaurus is because when Karn fights Ember Spire Witch, they still gain 2, which is awkward. Because there's games where you don't have orcs. And the Shard of Hatred's not making a temporary resource isn't a big deal, I don't think. Yeah, Sand seems great. Yeah, we only have 12 orcs, so I wanted to mitigate the number of games where just, like, they don't do anything. Again, this hand just wants to draw 2 to 3 resources, so I think we're gonna add a Crackling Vortex and maybe cut a Ruby Shard for another Crackling Vortex after this gauntlet. Bass, Chlorophylia, it's a good turn 2. Oh, you know, that was a mistake. I should have played Quash Ridge Rumble. I need to play this turn, but he could have a Carnosaur here to fight this, or like Ruby Shard burn and kill this, and then we're just like can't cast these Burning Tendrils because we don't have double Ruby. Definitely should have played this. This is the only orc in our hand. Pact of Life. Okay, yep. That's gonna be whenever he plays a resource, he gains 3. Well, ladies and germs, we're in for an uphill fight. Hopefully we draw a Ruby Shard this turn so we can use this to give rage and just not be punished for my mistake. Alright, well, we're just going to play this. We're just going to get our second Ruby this turn. I'm going to activate this and then do Infusion Device plus Burn this turn. Just be resource efficient. This does 4, this does 3, this does 2. Oh, wait. That was... I'm an idiot. I had in mind that we were going up to our fourth threshold, which meant, in my mind, we had 4 resources, but Infusion Device gave us one of those thresholds. Sorry. This is someone that doesn't want to lose to burn. We're bringing in all the Ember Spire, which is next game. Especially Ember Spire, which is really good on the play. They're all coming in, ladies and germs. He has Fight Dinos, too. Ember Spire, which is not good against this card. Maybe Burning Tendrils isn't good in this matchup. Wonder if he has another croc. I wouldn't be surprised if he had another croc here. That's a good reason to play out the first one. It's just a threat. Alright, things aren't looking good for the hero here. Oh, you want some chips? We have some chips. Mmm. These are your favorite, right? Lime chips? Would not mind some shards. Another crackling bolt. We're just going to pass the turn here. If we hit a shard next turn, we'll probably have to double crackling bolt this, which doesn't feel good, but is what it is. Getting Eye of Creation for infinite here. Tries to Tsilena's deck. Alright, and he has Cluckdowns too. Yeah, just ton of hate. Yeah, I don't think I want the Burning Tendrils. I definitely don't want Kiss. I think I want Whirling Brutalizer on the play. I'm gonna cut the Electrify. I'm gonna cut the Ghostblade Duelist, which might seem weird. But the fact that he has Cluckdons in his deck, the Succulent Cluckadon, makes the Ghostfire Duelist worse. Having two troops on the board is also a liability against all of his Crocosaurs. So I think trimming that is fine. We'll see, though. I mean, the consistent source of damage is generally pretty valuable. Sand's okay. It's got an Ebony Pawn on two. I think that's good enough. It's got Burn on one in case he's got his Howling Brave. Needs another Ruby Shard, but we draw Whirling Brutalizer in our first two draw steps. The hand's really good because Pawn into Brutalizer is fantastic. Cluck Duck in. The old Cluck-a-Duck-Duck-Duck. Cluck-a-Duck-Duck-Duck-Duck-Duck-Duck-Duck. Cluck-a-Duck in. I think we're just, like, obligated to kill this. I think this is one of the few things that we just want to spend this on. That's interesting. Yeah, I think I want to play this on two over the Ebony Pawn, right? That can just have the ability to start pushing a lot of damage very quickly. Okay. We'll see if he takes this trade here. If we draw a Ruby Threshold, we're going to Burning Tendrils this, so hopefully that happens. That's really unfortunate. Okay, I'll get you more chips. You gotta be patient, bud. Another double ruby card is the opposite of what we wanted to happen there. I'm gonna activate this and ship for two. I think that means he's not gonna block. Play this, play Ebony Pawn, activate Ebony Pawn, put some to 13. Probably going to get Turduckens next turn. Have Helgain 4, which is not good for us. Would really have liked to have played this out. Although I guess playing this out means he could croc us the following turn. It's all in this chest, none of it's good for us. I guess I'd rather this kills this than Ember Spire Witch. Glass half full. Get to search another Dark Spire out of our deck. Ruby Shard would be great. Maybe he doesn't have another shard. Yeah, he does. Come. Not convinced these are good. They might be fine. Not convinced, though. It's definitely worse against... it's worse against decks that... God! Ember Spire Witch! Oh, we've missed so much value not being able to play you. Come on, Ruby this turn so we can Burning Tendrils the Stork down. God bless you. Alright, let's activate this. Gets our Ebony Pawn to do a little more. Let's our Burning Tendrils do one more. Attack with this. If he blocks and we do damage, he takes four instead of three. Okay, is that 10? He's got a lot of life gain in his deck, though, like he showed us, so definitely not out of the woods. He has a shard. There's a shard here. He could go champ power activation root dead. Yeah, probably just dead to that. Yeah. So we're taking 16 here. Does 8 when it comes into play, and then I'm not going to miss this direct damage gem. There's no way this one doesn't get rotated when rotation happens. When they get rid of spell shield and direct damage will hopefully just both eat it at the same time. I will get you more chips. Calm down. So we're going to play Ember Spire Witch here. I'm going to chump with Dark Spire. Ooh, this stops Kiss from gaining life too. Okay. Dead to Shard, second Root Father. Dead to Eye of Creation into second Root Father. Balthazar. Alright. Draw 8 cards, don't gain any life. Set 5. It might even be before then. What you got? Just passing, okay. Please be 3 damage. Please be 3 damage. Please be 3 damage. Please be 3 damage. Yeah! Ah! Ooh, that's scary. Okay, we can gain some life now. So what kills him here? Crackling Bolt? Is it exactly Crackling Bolt? I think it's exactly Crackling Bolt. Dark Spire. That doesn't do it, right? Oh, it might do it. Well, it technically does 3. Shard 2. No, Shard didn't do it. Shard was only 3, 4, 5. Yeah, Shard was 1 short. Yeah, good beats. Maybe I'm supposed to play out Ember Spire Witch to play around a second Balthazar here. My hope was that he just shipped with the squad and then blocked and we Vampire Kiss him and then get 3 damage off the trigger, but yeah, we're just dead there. Alright, we're bound to lose a match eventually, right? Alright, we're in a quick commercial and we'll be back with a few more. Hopefully finish out this gauntlet today. Thanks for hanging out, folks. I mean, that's why we play the games, instead of just, like, you know, looking at the champions and comparing the deck lists and then saying who wins. Like, sometimes you win your hard matchups. Sometimes you lose your easier matchups. I don't think so, Ace. We'll see. I'm recording a podcast tonight. It's actually a Hex podcast tonight with someone. I'm blanking on his name right now, from 8 to 9, so probably not. It's going to hard sell the wife to do that and stream. Weather's pretty nice here. Probably going to take the kids out. And the 12-hour stream is tomorrow, so probably, yeah, I'm not, definitely not a late stream tonight. Void two troops you control, create an abomination with power equal to 3 plus their combined power, and put it into play. That's interesting. Okay. Awesome. Hopefully see you there, mate. And if not, you will automatically be entered in all of the drawings that we do for the subs. We've got a pretty good curve here. We get to curve Ebony Pawn into Brutalizer. Although I guess we could curve Arena Regular into Brutalizer too, right? Not sure which of those is actually better. Probably the Arena Regular getting on the table, since it's a troop that can attack. Kind of Blood Wild Shinhair Brew, it looks like. 25 starting life is a big chunk of life to deal with. Get blood, play my arena regular. I think it's pretty important that Hex hits their next set release goal. If they fall short again, it's not going to instill a lot of confidence. This set 4 had a lot of delays for a number of outside factors, but evolve. Okay. Magic or Hex? Are there going to be a little bit of both, Boris? No attack is interesting. What am I doing here? I think I'm actually just activating this. No, I'm not going to activate that yet. I'm just going to play this, do one, Burning Tendrils his dork, and then hit him for two more. One of the giveaways for the subs is pretty valuable, though. It's a foil 7th edition Birds of Paradise, which is about $200 retail. No, I don't think so, Immortals. Things like Game Night really don't pull in people, I don't think, that wouldn't otherwise come. This enters play, target opposing champion reveals a random card from their hand, revealed troops get -2/-2. 1 in 5 chance to kill my Whirling Brutalizer. So this turn, we're going to activate my champion power so we can Burning Tendrils our way through this dork that he just played out. So then this does 2 to my opponent from Arena Regulars, getting 1 extra. Burning Tendrils does 4 here, plus 3 up top, and then Arena Regulars does 2 when it attacks. He game night to keep the wife happy. Oh, is this one of the starter decks? I believe that. Okay. All right, so next turn he's dead, probably. Yeah, exactly. I'm excited for the ladder for that reason. So let's activate this. Shard does 2. Crackling Bolt does 6. Whirling Brutalizer does infinite. Yeah. Dead opponent. Arr. Be ready to be brutalized. Ladder will be free, right? What about new AAs? You get them in... Yep, ladder's completely free to play in, and you get Pax Gold and Altar Arts just for playing it. Reserving. Cleave's probably great. One Electrify is probably fine. Probably don't need Kiss. Opponents doesn't seem particularly aggressive. Sounds pretty good. Turn 1 Ghostfire, turn 2 Arena Regular, some interaction for his troops. Hey, there are chips right here. Do not knock the bag on the floor. Little turd meister. Toddler turd. My god, that's a good draw. So we get to go Ghostfire Duelist here, Blood Shard, Arena Regular. The following turn we go activate Infusion Device, Shard, Crackling Bolt. Just like infinite damage. Oh, Thomas ended. Oh, you're reaching for the phone, not the... Yeah. Say duh, Dad. Is your brother awake? Your brother is awake. All right, we'll grab him after this game. And we'll go grab him now. All right, I'll be right back. I'm going to take a quick second to run upstairs and grab my other toddler out of his crib. He's up from his nap. Thanks for hanging out, folks. Don't go anywhere, we're gonna finish out this gauntlet.
Well, I was gonna do my turn really quick, but he's taking a while, so I'm gonna be right back.
Oh, here, Tucker. I'm gonna get you, brother.
Sorry about that.
This guy for big lit on fire. Burn, baby, burn. No blocks. Alright, so we're going to activate my champion power. Which then lets this. And we actually don't need the extra threshold. So let's give my Orc Rage 1. Does 2 to my opponent from my arena regular. Infusion device does 2 to my opponent from my arena regular. Crackling Bolt. I'm going to attack first in case we need to burn a surprise blocker. Do 3, okay, Ghostblade does 2, Crackling Bolt does 6. It's a lot of damages. A lot of damages. So we've done 16 already, and it's turn 3. It's not bad. Might even turn 4 kill. Probably turn 4 kill, right? We activate this, and this does 2, this does 4. This does 7. Yeah, we got a turn 4 kill here. Turn 4 kill against a 25 life champion is not bad. We have overkill for the 25 life even. Oh, our Ghostblade Duelist is now a -1/-1. But thankfully he's just dead here. Activate this. Activate this. I don't even need the shard, do I? Oh, I have to play the shard to get my burn, though. Litten up! Alright, 4-1. The deck list starting to feel... The core of the deck feels good. The Dark Spire... I'm not sure on the Dark Spires yet. It's nice being able to play the Orc Shards consistently, though. I'm not... I think I want another shard total in the deck list. Probably a Crackling Vortex. I might even want 2 Crackling Vortex, be greedy and cut like a Blood Shard, perhaps. I don't think we want to cut a dual shard. I think I would cut like a blood shard first. Another Cressida. See if we win this time around or if last time was just a little bit of bad luck. Opponent also mulliganed. Our 6 is reasonable here. He has his dork on 1. This is the best start. This hand's not particularly good against turn 2 Hierophant. No little bunny foo-foo one time. No shin hair. Come on. Have a heart. God bless you. You big-hearted fellow, you. So I wasn't sure if I wanted to play Arena Regular or Darkspire Priestess this turn. The fact that I drew Whirling Brutalizer means I definitely want to play Arena Regular, because that means I can trigger Arena Regular and then get a Whirling Brutalizer trigger next turn. So he's a turn 2/4/4. That's pretty good. Let's see if that's able to keep up with the damage output that we're about to push here with this Brutalizer. Gaining 3 is pretty good. Hopefully this is... Yeah! Has to take the Ruby! God, this... It would be... There's no way he doesn't have a 5/5 here, right? There's no way there's no 5 here. I guess if his 5 is... His 5 is, Green Paw, we're in trouble. Man, I need to stop calling shots for my opponents. I'm so bad about that. I just keep calling out the cards that are crappy for us, and they have the cards that are crappy for us. Well, we're definitely activating this. The question is what we're doing afterwards. Play the Shard. Am I playing Burning Tendrils or am I playing Whirling Brutalizer? Brutalizer is just going to trade with one of these dorks. So I think I'm just supposed to Tendrils this guy. It's unfortunate. He didn't have the Shin here, I guess, so glass half full, kind of. Next turn, we go Shard, Pawn, Prince, Priestess. Seems a little bit too slow on the draw. I think if we were on the play... Yeah, if we were on the play, he'd be down more life by now. It's unfortunate. We have a second Green Paw. Yeah, I don't think we're beating that. This matchup might be bad for us. Like I said, on paper, I'd assume we're good against the 17 health champion, but just like the stuff that they push out and like the life gain gems, the life gain shards that they have, it's probably not great. It's definitely a matchup where Electrolyze is better than Heat Wave. I might go back and split the difference and do 2/2 on Electrofry and Heat Wave. Cleave seems fine. Electrofry seems fine. Whirling Brutalizer does not seem good. Bring in the extra kiss is a deal 3. Let's try this. Again, maybe I want the Ember Spire, which is... Heat Wave is still good. I don't think Heat Wave is worth bringing in this matchup. Our troops are pretty important. And, like, Heat Wave's not dealing damage to your opponent. Remember, a card has to be really very, very important. Like, must have every game or die to not... I guess it's okay. We don't even know he has Hierophant, though. Like, if I would have saw Hierophant, I'd definitely bring in Heat Wave, but... Play first. Easy mulligan. Medium keep. Now turn one plays good for us. Again, wish I just had shard, so Crackling Vortex / 23rd shard, definitely going to be good. Crackling Vortex is nuts with this card. Crackling Vortex plus Yotul with Arena Regular does 4, right? Come on, shard. Shard that makes a temporary resource. Shard that makes a temporary resource. Shard that makes a temporary resource. I was even specific and it didn't work. If I activate this, it's worth... Yeah, I'm just going to activate this. We're going to have two more charges again here. So this will do two here and two here. This shard will do two to my opponent, and then arena regular hit him for two. Being on the play is a big difference. Move that surprises no one. Winning the coin flip is good. He's got, even if he has a wabbit here, I think that's too slow. Geez, Smythe, sure, we've got the burning tendrils to cut through that. If it cost three charges to use Yotul, they could have given him more life to balance it out, which is one of the neat things they can do in this game. And I don't think this is overpowered. Like, we're winning, we're losing, you know, some games too. I 5x my gauntlets with most things. Game three, no Ruby. If he's got a Cluckodon, that would be annoying. Puts him back up to 14. That's fine. Shards start doing two damage now, which is good. So let's play this. Do I want to activate this? If I activate this, it's worth 2 points of damage. I think I'm going to hold this shard and pass the turn for now. If he goes shard croc, we get punished. Runeer doesn't matter. Attack. Attack me! Attacking me is really bad. Alright, so we want to draw burning tendrils here. Burn's not bad. So activate this. Is that lethal? That's lethal, right? Yeah, that's lethal. I think I'm just submitting. I think I'm happy with how we boarded. Yeah. I'm just gonna save. How does the resource system work? Check this out. It's a brief introduction to Hex that includes an explanation of the resource system. It's very, very short. Give that a once over, and then if you have any questions while we're playing the game, how I'm doing something, feel free to ask about specifics, or even just the examples from that article, Jester. I think the resource system is the very first thing we talk about in there, in fact. I love having things like that written. Sweet. Okay, so we're going to go... this for blood on one, probably. I guess the fact that this didn't make a resource this turn was a little clunky. Maybe we do want to cut one of those. Can't have Puck. That's a good one. Hopefully it doesn't have Howling Brave as well. Just double chloro. Okay. It's a lot of accelerant. Play arena regular out. Means next turn we can go champion activation, crackling bolt something if we need to, or just ebony pawn. Man, his draw is good this game. Let's see what his follow-up threat is. Very strong, though. Oh, jeez, he's going to gain three as well? Man, I don't think we ever beat this. If Cheese Smith is his only threat, maybe? Maybe? Why would you cycle that? Maybe he has another one? That's terrifying. I think you'd only cycle that if you have another one. Burning Tendrils. Another Arena Regular. So, yeah, I'm going to play Arena Regular out. I'm going to activate Yotul, deal two with this, and then burn his Cheese Smythe. His draw is good, but hopefully he just has ramp deck problems and doesn't have a bomb to follow up his good start. Well, here it comes. Yep, like I said, I think he'd only cycle the Arboreal Root Father if he had a second one. That's unfortunate. I think I'm just going to three here because we're never beating a second Arboreal Root Father anyway, so that's the only thing that blocking really plays around. I'd much rather play this Darkspire Priest next turn and throw it in front of this. In a world where my opponent doesn't have any more follow-up, we could win this game. You shouldn't play around things you can't beat, and we can't beat my opponent having anything else, so we're not going to play around him having anything else. And again, I think this... I don't even know. I have to play this matchup some more. Yeah. His draw... That was easily his best draw. So I don't want to say that that matchup's bad. We did our... Both of our losses are to Cressida decks, which feels weird. I guess they don't really have 17 life because, like, the life gain charge that they're playing for, they probably realistically have 20 to 23 life per game. But, like, double accelerant, burn my dork, threat Balthazar. Pretty rough. Feels bad to lose a coin flip. Feels good that he mulligans. Alright, down to five. Got him. I'm not sure I like this guy. Mulligan to four. Alright, keep. Last time our opponent mulliganed to four, we had a close game and barely won, so. Our hand's better this game than it was in that one, though. Hand's actually very good now with a third shard. Again, just like usually just want to draw shards, so should probably have one more. Gonna go Blood Shard, Arena Regulars. And then next turn we go activate Yotul, do this, do this, do this. He plays Hierophant here. We'll play Darkspire Priestess. Transmog. It's pretty good. Giving us a 4-3 is okay, though, as well. There's a lot of... Transmogging 2 drops is one of the scarier things you can do in this game. Opponent conceded. Hex also conceded. So this is my normal disclaimer. If you've seen me before, you've probably heard this. I'm playing Hex on an unsupported platform. Hex only officially supports Windows and OS X as platforms, and I'm streaming from a Linux computer using Wine technology. So occasionally it vomits on itself. Alright, so we're in reserving here against Boris. Heat waves in. Electrofry in. I think we usually bring the Cleaves in too. Whirling Brutalizer gets gummed up on the ground. Vampire Kiss isn't particularly good. I think I'm going to leave a 1 Brutalize over a Kiss. Go ahead and submit. Hey, Mortickle. What's going on, mate? Welcome. Yeah, seems pretty reasonable. Hopefully he has turned to Hierophant because we have a Heat Wave.
Play your Howling Brave. Do it. Yeah. Oh, no. Oh, no. Whatever will we do? He has the nut draw. And I don't know that I'm supposed to burn that guy. Why would I burn his guy? Please play a Hierophant. Do-da, do-da. Please play your Hierophant. Oh, the do-da day. Boom, ba da da dong, da 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 dong. Oh ho 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 ho. Somebody's gonna get heat waved. Bum 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 bum. Cyclone Shaper. Play Mr. Darkspire out. Play my Blood Infusion Device out. Did you get the PTR running with wine as well? I didn't actually play the play on the PTR server, so I'm hoping it runs via wine. It doesn't look like any of the changes are going to cause any. I don't know what the back end changes are, I guess, but it's using the Unity engine still, so I'd assume it still works. Hopefully he plays another Dark Out and we cast another Heat Wave next turn. With Yotul's ability, this Heat Wave will deal 3. Go ahead and attack with my Priestess. And just takes it. I'm going to go ahead and activate this and then cast Heat Wave here. Our guy either does damage to him or replaces itself. If he has a Verdict, I wouldn't be surprised to see him Verdict here. I guess he could have Counter Magic too, because this reduces the cost. Has Verdict. Huh. Do you want to kill this? I feel like that's a losing proposition. Yeah, I'm just gonna send the burns upstairs. Each of these do 3 while we have Yotul activation going. Going to 12. Cleave should be pretty good. Go. Ebony Pawn's not bad. Attack with this. I'm going to activate this and cast the Cleave here. There might be merit to just Infusion Devicing, but I kind of like getting his threat off the table. Swings the race in our favor by a good margin. Alright, so that's reason to wait on that, I guess. Still on a 3-turn clock, and he's mostly on a 3-turn clock. We've got 2, 5, 6. Yeah, so he's on a 3-turn clock as well. He has Counter Magic. Maybe he has Counter Magic. He might have just had the Brown Fox Coat. That's pretty good. Shard. Crackling Bolt. So if I block here, I take lethal. If I Crackling Bolt this, I don't. So we're dead if he has a removal spell. But he's dead otherwise. This does 4, 5, 6, so if he doesn't have a removal spell and this hits damage, our opponent dies. Sure. Still not dead, and that's the only number I care about. So we have to win the coin flip, win the game. And even if he doesn't attack with these, we can still win the coin flip when we attack him. Because either he blocks in these trade and then we get a coin flip, or it deals 2 and then we just kill him with these. This is 4, 5, 6 with our champion activation. This fun makes me feel sick. Not at all, my friend. It's splendid. It will help Coin flip. Yeah, coin flips. One is not none. One is not none. One is not none. Got him. Ha, got him. Okay, that's a 5-2. Sweet. All right. Let's take a look. I'm going to run a quick commercial, and we'll take a look at this deck and see what changes we want to make. But that's 2 5Xs in a row. This deck feels really good. For those of you still watching, you either have Adblock or you're one of my wonderful subs, so we're going to talk about changes I want to make to the deck here in just a momento. Oh, I guess I can odds right there. Actually, I can clear my mails. Oh, look at that. Someone sent me AA Whirling Brutalizers. Weird, I'd be casual. At any rate, that is done. Look at that. Because this chick is ugly. Alright, so that's a cosmetic change that we've now made. Which I appreciate. He's scary looking too, but I think he's less scary looking, maybe. I think so. Anywho, changes we want to make. So, I've talked a couple times about wanting more shards. Weird. Yeah, I'm not too worried about it. The Shard of Hatred, I think we can afford to cut this. I'm not sure. So, let's see. So, let's give away this deck during long stream. That's not a bad idea. This deck's pretty cheap. Maybe I'll do that. I think I can get together an extra copy of this deck for pretty cheap. I've got a bunch of packs I could sell. So I want 2 Crackling Vortexes, I think. I only had one of those and it was a magic related thing. So, I need to try and sell ad space. I don't know, it's tough. Manually finding ad space is bleh. Ads plus 1 intimidation factor. So, I wanted plus 1 shard total, and I think I want to trim a Shard of Hatred. Where even trimming a Shard of Hatred, we're at 18 ruby and then 9, 13 blood, which I think is fine. And then I need to cut one other card here. I could see a Vampire Kiss going. I could also see Dark Spire Priestess going. Drawing multiple of these has been a little clunky, but I want at least a few of them because we want our orc count to be high enough to play Quashridge Rubble, I think. I think I'm going to trim a Priestess as opposed to a Kiss. I kind of like the Kisses. We have a nice, really pretty clean curve here. I think I'm pretty happy with the rest of this. As far as the reserves go, someone mentioned the heat waves being expensive. I really don't like the heat waves, and I really don't love the Crimson Bolt. I think I want a second Electrofry for against the various Green Paw Emancipator decks. I started with 3 of these. I agree we want some heat waves against to like kind of combat their
the Runeer Hierophant Nut Draw, but I think I just rather have some Electrofries. And I kind of want, plus upside. So adding Crackling Vortex is counterintuitive to playing Rage Fire. I think if I wanted to play Rage Fire, I'd want 19 or 20 Ruby thresholds, because we need to play our cards early and consistently. I also like that Vampire Kiss buffers our life total a little bit in this deck. Like, the fact that Kiss gains 3 is huge. Like, this gains life equal to the damage dealt, which means you're gaining 3 with your activation. You want to think of all of your cards basically in terms of damage to card ratio. I think I want another Cleave in here. McBombus is becoming more popular, the Prophecy Bombus deck, and I think Cleave is really good in that matchup. Hey, Ulthar. I think Cleave is really, really powerful against that deck. We might be a little bit light on Vampire Answers, but honestly, we have Crackling Bolt and Burning Tendrils in the main deck, plus Ember Spire, which can just, like, let us ignore the text on Vampires, so I think that's more than enough Vamp Answers that we don't need a Crackling Bolt in the 75. The Rage Fire! This might also be too many cards. Actually, it's kind of funny, so we want to bring in all of these threes against Bombus. So, like, one of the things you should do when you're, like, talking about, like, building your reserves and thinking about, like, what cards you want is, I want to bring in all 7 of these cards right now against Bombus. So we should look at my main deck and go, well, what cards do I want to cut when we're playing against McBombus? And I think, see, I don't think I have 7 cards I want to cut against McBombus. I think the Whirling Brutalizers are probably bad in that matchup because McBombus has 4 burns post-reserves, probably plus a couple of transmogs. So there's going to be a lot of times where Whirling Brutalizer just doesn't deal any damage to our Bombus opponent. So I think we have 4 slots that are easily cut. But honestly, I think it might just be those 4. I guess it could be 4 plus some of the Ghostblade Duelists, but like Ghostblade Duelist on 1 is a really strong play, and usually it deals some amount of damage to my opponent. But I guess if I want to cut Ghostblade Duels, I actually have 1 card too few for the Bombus matchup. I could see just boarding an Electrofry, though, too. Like, maybe I just want the Electrofry in that matchup, similar to the reason why I like Cleave. I don't know. I'm going to have to think about it. I think that's going to be my last match for the day. I want to go ahead and get dinner ready for the kids. Getting 10 after 4 here. We're going to go for a walk. It's a beautiful day outside. Tomorrow is going to be my next long stream. It's going to be a minimum of 12 hours with a donation goal extension to 24 hours. We hit that last time, which was a trip. So we'll see. Grim might be good. What does that do? Grim Tutor? Is that what you mean by Grim? I don't think this card's very good. Grim Justice? Which card for Grim? This one? Oh, I guess this kills one of their idiots and brings one of our idiots back? I don't hate that. Huh. Yeah, we'll set that up tomorrow. So the details on what the long stream